Hi, this is Barbara from LiveBinders, and today I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily make a free virtual binder. So let's take a look at some virtual binders before we get into building one ourselves. These are several binders that are up on our site. This is a real estate company that puts together a package of information for their clients. And you can see that this is an uploaded document here. This is their flyer on this particular investment. You can put websites, you can put videos, you can put uploaded documents. This is a live website that's in here. You can have tabs and subtabs. And the tabs can be on the left, they can be on the top, they can be on the right side of your virtual binder. You get to choose. So let's look at another binder. This is one of mine. This has a video in here. You can embed videos in your binder. We automatically create a table for of contents for you if you like. And you can see I also have in here my presentation that I used and my cheat sheet for the presentation, as well as a whole bunch of backup sites and information that I gave to the people who attended my conference. So that's a quick overview of some LiveBinders. If you want to sign up for an account, you just click on sign up and it brings you to this page, and you can sign up with Google or you can sign up with email. Once you've signed up, you'll see your very first binder on your shelf. If you mouse over it and you click on edit, you will see an overview of how to get started here. And this is a video and some quick steps that will help you get started on your LiveBinder. Once you're done, you can just delete this tab and you'll have your first binder with all your information in it. But I'll show you quickly how to do that. So here's my second tab, and I can just type in here. If I want to add something to this tab, I click on content and I can add text, I can add videos or images, I can upload a document. This is just a screenshot of LiveBinders. I can upload that. And there's my file in my LiveBinder. And I can just continue to add tabs and subtabs this way. Add a new subtab, and it puts it under my current tab. Add another subtab. So it's pretty straightforward. Now, if I want to make my binder look pretty, I go to settings, and I can change the name of the binder and the description tags. I can even change the author name that appears. I could change the colors of the tabs. Let's pick a nice bright color. I can change the layout of the tabs. Now, if I change this, you won't see this in the editor. Tabs on the left, but you will see it. People viewing the binder will see it. I can have the overview tab in the first tab and a table of contents in the second tab if I like, or not show either one of those. And I'll show you what that's going to look like. I can change the cover of my binder. This is our little default cover. I can choose a file from here, or I can actually choose it from the tab. I'm going to put the LiveBinders logo in here. And the last thing I want to show you is the access. So the binder is just a link that can be copied. You can make it public or private. If it's private and you want to share it, you need to add an access key. But you can also embed the binder. You can embed a whole shelf of binders. There's lots of ways to share your LiveBinder. So let's see how this is going to look in play mode. So you can see I put that overview tab as the first tab, and what it has is my description. and my logo, my table of contents, and then my new tab that I created here. So that's it. It's pretty fast to create a binder. The last thing I want to show you is how to add links quickly to a binder. So if you're on a website and you want to add it to a binder, I'm going to go back here to my binder, scroll all the way to the bottom, and click on Bookmarklet. This is a bookmarklet that can be added to your browser. And when you are on a website that you want to add to your binder, you just click on that Live Binder It button, and it brings up a little menu that lets you select which binder you want to add it to and change the name of the tab, put it in a subtab, or add a comment as well. So that's a way to quickly add links to a Live Binder. If you want to quickly add a lot of files to a binder, you want to go to My Uploaded Files here. And here's where you can upload multiple files at a time and then quickly add them to a binder. That's it. That's how you create a digital binder for free. And LiveBinders lets you have up to 5 digital binders all for free. Thanks for listening.